In fact, some scientists are beginning to suggest that despite the catastrophic worldwide wildfires, there's a possibility that some dinosaurs could have survived. One of these scientists is David Kring of the Lunar and Planetary Institute. The cause of the wildfires was the dust and rocks ejected very high into space. As they fell back to Earth, they were superheated by the friction with the air, igniting serious, massive wildfires on the surface. The majority of the dinosaurs were thought to have died when the flames spread very quickly throughout the globe. But when a simulation was conducted to see how the superheated wave spread from the impact point, the results were quite unexpected. Surely, the heat wave spread with time. However, there were certain locations where the heat wave did not reach, which are displayed in black.
Those wildfires did not occur everywhere. The distribution of wildfires was uneven across the globe.
Furthermore, another scientist points out that there was a place that was particularly untouched by wildfires. Seiji Sugita of the University of Tokyo is a world authority on meteoroid impacts. Sugita analyzed the traces of the asteroid impact on the Yucatan Peninsula. When the impact point was scanned with specialized techniques, a crater 180 kilometers wide appeared underwater. Close examination showed that the crater was open at the top. This revealed that the bedrock melted by the impact flowed in a northwesterly direction. Sugita says that this occurred because the asteroid impacted at an angle from the south in a northerly trajectory. He also points out that this caused greater damage in the northern hemisphere and conversely less damage in the southern hemisphere.
え、南の方から巨大隕石が飛来して、で、その結果非常に高温の巨大な火の玉のようなものが北米の方にこうバーッと飛んでいくんですけども、北米に限らず、他のヨーロッパとかアジアも含めて大きな影響を与えた可能性が高くてですね、この影響は南半球に関しては非常に限定的であったというふうに我々は考えています。
During the dinosaur age, there was a supercontinent called Gondwana in the southern hemisphere. It gradually split apart about 66 million years ago. The land masses of South America, Antarctica, and Australia were still connected. And scientists now believe, on the southern continent, far from the impact site, the damage may have been limited, and the dinosaurs living there could have had a good chance to survive. Several days after the asteroid impact, this is where the Puertasaurus hid in the cave. Even though they've survived the superheated wave and the wildfires, they're now starving. it's not only the two Puertasaurus that have survived. So have their predators. They are desperately searching for food. They could need up to 100 kilograms per day. It's a Mayipe, the most powerful carnivorous dinosaur in South America at the time. The male juvenile uses all the strength that's left. In the end, this lone and weakened Mayipe that has strayed from its pack doesn't have the strength to attack a larger prey. The juvenile sauropods have escaped with their lives. But if they don't find anything to eat, they'll surely die. There still are some plants. In the vicinity of Patagonia, where they lived, scientists are starting to think that there may have been a region that received very little damage. By pure chance, the young Puertasaurus are headed in that direction. It's the southern tip of the southern hemisphere, the modern-day Antarctica and its vicinity. Research has revealed that Antarctica at that time was relatively warm and was home to a variety of dinosaurs. In Antarctica and its environs, there still could have been food to sustain the dinosaurs. In fact, an interesting fossil that could prove this hypothesis has been found. It was found on a tiny island in Chile, near Antarctica, at the southern tip of South America. This is Harufumi Nishida of Chuo University, who reported the discovery in 2015. He's an internationally respected authority on paleobotany. Seed fern was a plant that flourished in the dinosaur age. For a long time, scientists believe that they became extinct as a result of the asteroid impact. But the fossil Nishida found was dated to around 5 million years after the collision.
Some
paleontologists agree. One of them is Julia Clark of the University of Texas at Austin, a world-renowned paleontologist and evolutionary biologist. She's been excavating dinosaur fossils in the Antarctic.